Good morning, dear children. Yesterday, we finished question answers of civics, that is, fill in the blanks and answer in one sentence. Today, we'll go for the question number 3. What do you think? Answer in 2 or 3 sentences. Here, what do you think? Answer in 2 or 3 sentences. How is a society formed? So, here the answer is, man requires security and stability. When man realized that he can have security by living together with others, he started living in an organized life. Man realized that for orderly conduct of the affairs of the society, there was a need for regulation. How can he maintain regulation? So thereby, society came into existence for the attainment of certain common objectives. I'll read the answer again. How is the society formed? Man requires security and stability. When man realized that he can have security by living together with others, he started living an organized life. Man realized that for orderly conduct of the affairs of the society, there was a need for regulation. So, the society came into existence for the attainment of certain common objectives. Second, why is it necessary to set up a permanent system in society? Why is it necessary to set up a permanent system when they're living in a society? It is necessary to set up a permanent system in society to fulfill the basic needs of the people. To conduct the social affairs which cannot take place without any provision for regulation. The very existence of the society depends on setting up some permanent systems. Some permanent systems are also necessary for a stable social life. I'll read the answer again. It is necessary to set up a permanent system in the society to fulfill the basic needs of the people. To conduct the social affairs which cannot take place without making provisions for regulation, then the very existence of the society depends on setting up some permanent systems. Some permanent systems are also necessary for a stable social life. Next question over here. What makes a life in society more stable and organized? What makes a life in the society more stable and organized? The factors that make the social life more stable and organized are as follows. That is, first, to fulfillment of the basic needs, that is food, clothing and shelter. First point is to fulfillment of the basic needs, that is food, clothing and shelter. Second, arrangements for security. There should be some security for the people. Third point, mutual dependence among the different sections of the society. There should be mutual understanding between the society. Opportunities made available to the individuals to develop the inherent skills and capability. Some opportunities are available for the individuals to develop their skills and capability. Fifth point, regulation in the form of customs, tradition, norms and laws. Again, first point, I'll read again the answer. The factors that make the social life more stable and organized are as follows. That is, fulfillment of basic needs of food, clothing and shelter, arrangements for security, mutual understanding or dependence among the different sections of the society, opportunities which are being made available to the individuals to develop their skills and capability, regulation in the form of customs, tradition, norms and laws. Next question. If there were no social institutions, what difficulties would we have faced? If there were no institutions, what difficulties we have to face over here? We would have faced the following difficulties if there was no society. man would have remained in the nomadic stage, wandering from place to place in search of food. Man would have remained perpetually insecure and unstable. Law of the jungle would have prevailed in the absence of rules. Emotional, psychological, and physical needs of man would not have been satisfied. Then the development of personality would not have taken place. I'll read the answer again. Man would have faced the following difficulties if there was no society. Man would have remained in the nomadic stage, wandering from place to place in search of food. Man would have felt insecure and unstable. Law of the jungle would have prevailed in the absence of rules. Emotional, psychological, and physical needs of man would not have been satisfied. Development of personality would not have been taken place. Next question is based on what would you do in the following situations? Your friend has forgotten to bring something they need in the school. What would you do? So you would tell your friend, "Don't worry, I have got it. You can share with me." Your friend has forgotten to bring something they need in school. You will tell your friend, "Never mind, forget it. Don't worry. I have got the book or pen, whatever you need, I will share with you." Second question, you meet a blind or otherwise handicapped person on the way. What would you do? If you met a blind person on the way or disabled person, what will you do? You will express some sympathy and help that person. So you will show some sympathy and you will help that person, whether he wants to cross the road or whatever he wants. So you have to show your sympathy and then help that person. So my dear children, this chapter's question answer also I have given you now. If you have written, well and good. If you have not written, please write it down. Next is the activities. Meet a skilled tradesman who makes farmer's tools. Make a list of those who help the farmer in his work. Now you can write that farmer's tools and who can help them. Second one is visit a nearby bank and find out the different purposes for which the bank lends money. You can go to different banks and ask them, what does he gives or lends money? Make a list of man's basic needs and some additional needs. Now you can write this basic needs, that is food, clothing, shelter. What are some additional needs they need? You find out from your parents and you can write down that. So chapter number 2 will go it for tomorrow. Thank you. Have a great day.